I'm going the wrong way, is that why? And now I'm gonna double back and then end up just going back the way I came because maybe that's the right way. Maybe I got messed up at that turn. Not very happy with this. I think it did go back. Doesn't this look exactly the same as when we approached it? So we're here. Where do we go? I'm not supposed to go through here, am I? Look, right through here? No. So I came from here and was approaching this. Let me just see. I think that's what we ended up doing. We ended up turning back and going the other way because... There's no path there. I don't understand. Climb up to get a better view of things. I was so confused right now. Is there even a path beyond that? There's a path here and it just ends. Am I supposed to climb on that or something? Oops. good stock now. Maybe I'm supposed to climb on that. I think I ended up turning around instead. Gotta stop doing that. Am I supposed to climb on this? Wait. She didn't say I'm supposed to jump. Okay. That's what we're supposed to do? I hope so. Alright.
In the folding of this song from my lips, how she came down like light from nothing. To salvage something beautiful from all this horror, this mindless hour, when the world blackens beneath her. Some shining thing cleaned of its ashes, and brightly to signal those lost to see. In such a land we take no notice of broken statuary. Being such as we are, we'll grind the stone, rubble worked to meal and mortar, foundations of torso, arms of empire.
She was damned since the moment she ate that frog from the swimming pool. She just could not stand a chance to lock tight and look right for another curse. Just like dwarfs from a shiny little town, she disappeared into a mist formed by droplets of nothingness that precipitate upwards into a void of finite infinity. I remember that last line, finite infinity. Alright, very sparkly and twinkly. Back to the road and make a left. The road is... that's kind of far off on the road. No more getting lost. Very bad. Don't get stuck either, because then I think I can't go that way, and then I'm going the wrong way. I don't know why, guys. This part's just the worst for me. I don't know if this is typical. But I'm really not liking this. I mean, it's not a maze. It's just like ending up going back. Because I can't see landmarks to tell when I'm going the wrong way. And we need some statues to, like, stand out. It's really just this path, and we're going up and down and around, and there's rocks and there's trees. Ah, slowing me down. You know, I'm worried I'm going to see those two houses again. Because the last time we slowed down, we saw the two houses, and it took us a while to get there and to realize it was the same two houses. Please, no. Can't be, though. Not this time.
We make paste of angel bone, broken idol quite fallen, uncrowned of laurels, sprinkled as bone meal in the furrows of the world.
Yeah.
A sign waiting to be found, unsearched for. Her presence purifies dialect, giving birth, even in death, to black suns of revelation.
Right.
She bestows an ephemeral royalty to our chaos, grants us impatient endurance. Ransacked and ravished, she brandishes over pale winter the flowering scepter of her disdains.
Okay. Why can't you talk about the fisherman again or about your mother? Like, actually tell me a story. I have no idea what you're talking about. You make paste out of angel bones? I mean, I get that I'm not supposed to be taking it literally, but I don't know how to take it any other way. How can you metaphorically make paste out of angel bones? Oh, here's another statue. Tonguc's.
And the path goes on and on and on.
On? Yeah, no kidding. So we can get closer to this one. That's the archer, yeah.
We adored her star in its blue-green burning, kindled her heart in ancient caves, and mantled the world in her first love. Forgive us our birth. Our lips have not yet drunk the utterance of your several storms. In the lifting of this stream from my slumber, how the dawn came down like water from nothing. There is no greater love than this. She sleeps. Quiet as death. And more lovely, wrecked but shouldering thunders.
How do you shoulder thunders? You could shudder with thunders, or have earth shuddering thunders, thunderstorms. How does a person shoulder thunder? Speed me up. This way. Oh no, I just started jumping. So I take it this is a safer path than the red path. It's just longer and more boring, I guess. I can't speed up yet. No, no. Okay. And you can do it. You can do it. Caught my eye for some reason. Just a plant. Looks like a carving this time. It looks like a face, kind of. A head. What's this? Interesting. Whatever it is, it's partially destroyed.
I remember waking in the dewy blue field at dawn and rushing back to see the potter.
Oh, me too.
I knew that Mother and Father would be worried and looking for me, but I had to have some answers about this dream. The potter was still writing at his desk, candles burnt down to stumps. At some point in the night, he had made a beautiful clay chalice that now lay in pieces on the floor. He didn't even look up. Go home, child. You have all the answers you will ever have.
This way. Hey. Look at the rocks there clinging to the side of that mountain. Whee! Oh boy! Ugh. I didn't intend that. Okay, we took a little shortcut. To go that way, to take a shortcut, but I don't want to get off the track and get lost. Crap like that. Song restarts.
I returned home where my father greeted me with silent hugs and a knowing look. He is a weaver, not only of fibers, but of words. He keeps the stories of the people and tells them as he weaves. So our history is in the warp and woof of every basket, every blanket, every winter cap. I remember sitting with him among the standing stones in the reaping season when the grasses had grown as tall as me. His voice was in tune with the dry seed pods scraping along rock as they swayed in the breeze. He pinched off the stalks of three and began to braid them together as he spoke.
And he said what? At least now she's kind of making more sense with what she's saying. I'm not talking about turning angel bones into paste and stuff like that. I really don't get that.
Do you know why you're special, Lula? He asked.
Comma, Lula.
Because I am the youngest, I guessed. He laughed. And so shall you always be. It looked like he was making a bracelet with the grass braid. But there is something else that makes you rare among our people. I am a weaver. This you know. Some are hunters. Others are foragers. Some are builders. While others are collectors. Just as your mother was a walker, born with a fierce curiosity to explore beyond the next horizon.
But I thought she rejected her path. The mother. I forget what they said she was supposed to be, and then that wasn't it, and so she left town when Lula was 8. Pretty much a straight line here, more or less. You can speed it up now. Flash me. Sometimes I think I see something and it's just a rock or a bush. And then I'm kind of disappointed.
He stopped braiding for a moment as his eyes squinted at the horizon, as if hoping to spot something very far away. Then, in a near whisper, "You are rare among our people because you are both weaver and walker."
Right.
"You are something more than both. You are a maker."
A maker.
And with that, he took my hand, slipped the grass bracelet around my wrist, and said, "Remember that almost nothing is ever what it seems. Beneath the surface is layer upon layer of history, all the little things that together make the whole."
Right. Well, she ended up... the genie created her, I think, and then she ended up creating all her family and all the people in the town, so she is a maker then. So I wish it would go fast again. I wonder if he just sped it up for like as a pacing thing. So there wouldn't be like a half hour sometimes between, you know, the dialogue, the voiceovers. Just seems weird to, you know, arbitrarily turn on the fast run again and then turn it off. Music went bye-bye. Now what happens?
Knowing this, there can never be good or bad, dark or light. Things only seem this way because we don't know the whole story. Even now, you are choosing your path and making your own story. But your story is special because it will become the history of our people. One day, you will have an important decision to make that will determine the story of all of us. He stood and smiled down at me. What is life, if not the longest introduction? You will meet the genie, and perhaps, more importantly, the genie will meet you.
Yeah. So life is an introduction to what? Death? Not living? Twisty, turny path. kind of glad I did the red one first, because I would have assumed... I mean, it might have said so, that it was shorter. But I might have assumed that they would both be as long as this one is. And it is frustrating and convoluted. Another one of these stones that don't have red things around them. Or blue things, rather.
He spoke of the genie long before my dream, where the wizard told me to find it. How could my father have known? Perhaps that is where my mother went, away to find the genie. She never wanted to be a walker, and thought she should have been a weaver. She seemed sad all the time, until, one day, she simply walked away.
That's what she does.
Perhaps she came this way. If she found the genie, what did she find?
Her doom. So she didn't want to be a walker, she wanted to be a weaver, but yet, in the end, she walked. And I think the father is a weaver. So the two of them together made Lula, who is walker and weaver. Though that doesn't ordinarily happen. Wait. This is the path, right? Okay. Geez, are we gonna get to anything new? I don't wanna bore the audience that much. Get to some kind of cave or something. Maybe some little platforming thing. Pull a lever. Change of scenery. Oh. Ah. My wish is its command. This looks very familiar, though. It's just like at the, where we got from the red path. That's a very loud torch. Oh, there's these mushrooms. Now if it's like the other one, we go to the right and there's a lever that will open up something, I assume, to the left. Or ahead, rather. I'm glad we got this far. Did the torches burn with blue? I don't remember seeing that. That might be because of the path we're on as well, and these mushrooms that are blue. I feel like I'm in a monastery.
Thank you.
mushroom path. What's that? Probably just a rock. Thought it was somebody laying on the ground, but nope, it's a rock. This is closed off, and I don't see...
How can I open that?
I need to see a lever or another passage to go.
Ta-da!
Ooh! Oh, good God. I'm pretty strong. I didn't realize that could happen. Back down we go. I'm supposed to go up the mountain.
I remember the miller when he still lived in the village, before he moved the mill deep into the forest and away from people. He had been making strange machines that ran on water power, sometimes very hot water. He made machines for work, for moving and lifting heavy things, for cutting and clearing trees. Very strong machines with wheels and cogs and noisy parts.
The people became
afraid and began to whisper that the miller was quite mad.
Yeah, and the fisherman was mad too. Well, you created these people, right? So they're a product of your own insanity then. Keep checking now and then to see if I can speed up, and it's just not doing it automatically. But you'd see a flash of white as well. I just wanted to speed up. It'd be really nice if it did. But no! We can't have that.